Building extensions on your house for sunblock, excellent idea, and cuts down the heat. Nothing better than cutting the heat and rain from the house. Very, very good. The other side, you can put concrete wood if you want. It'll look a lot nicer. I use plasterboard, but the plasterboard's rubbish to go outside. So smart board or future board. Carport or a place you could make a kitchen if you wanted, if it's outside the house. I just use it for the car. Simple to build. 2 days to build, no problems at all for one man. And small sunshades for outside windows, excellent as well, cut out the heat. It's amazing how much heat comes through your window. So just build that and you'll be happy. And like I say, at the back of the house, the whole length of the house, we've got sunshade. So it's really good. And cuts out the heat. Also keeps the rain from your front door. You can sit outside your front door, which is really nice. That's the dog's place, by the way. No, for me, my dog stays here. That's where I sit. But don't use plasterboard. Don't, outside. Use smart board. If you're going to do the ceilings, this smart board, smart board. Another. This one's no for sun, this one's for rain. When the rain used to come, it used to go inside the house. So I built this one and added a smart board as well. This one is basically is to keep the water from coming inside the house. I'll go and show you there's another one here, exactly the same. Keeps the heat right off the house. This one's a really good size. But if you've got spare cash in that, you know, you keep the heat off the buildings as much as you can. I like to do it. There's another one, a one bedroom villa, and excellent. And you can really, really cut the heat down. Oh, look at actually the decor there. It's a massive one, eh? Wow. Dok, dok. Massive, massive. But sunshades, and you can sit here. You can sit here and just relax and keep the heat out of your house, and you can look on the pool all day and no get the sun on your head. I'll show you another really loud one. This one's a massive one. This one's for, originally it was only 3 meters for to sit here. Then I decided to make a place to park the car and a place you could maybe sit outside and relax. So this one's just concrete. You could have you could make it in the house if you wanted to. But it's a massive area. Park two cars in it, or you could have functions in it as well. So that's basically your extension here, and that's the roof area. But if you've got spare cash, do it. And when you're building if you're building a extension kitchen or anything like that, extend the roof as far as you can. That one's only extended by maybe, just say, 1 meter. You really want to go further, like to the wall is, and take the water right back for your house. That's what you want to do, and the sun. Keep the sun out as well. So think what you're doing, and build extensions as big as you can. Then you cut back for an extra 5,000 back to make a good job. Spend a wee bit extra and make it work.